The idea for this protocol comes from Steve Belevin and Michael Merritt back in 1992. There have been many, many variations on this protocol, many of which are still in use today. And this protocol starts from Diffie-Hellman, which you should remember from Unit 3, where each party starts. They've agreed on the generator and some modulus. The client picks a random XA value, raises G to that power, sends the result to the server. The server picks a random XB value, raises G to that power, and sends the result to the client. They can both now compute the same key by raising the value they received to the power of their random value. The problem with Diffie-Hellman for authentication is if there's an active attacker, that attacker can change the values, send something different, set up a shared key independently with each party, and act as a middle attacker, intercepting all the traffic because the attacker knows the keys on these two separate channels. The idea of encrypted key exchange is to combine this with symmetric encryption to allow the client and server to authenticate each other, even if there's a middle attacker. Here's how it works. So I assume there's some password that at the beginning of the protocol is known to both the client and the server. Then the way this protocol works, the message that the client will send to the server, instead of just being the message that would be sent in Diffie-Hellman, is now that message encrypted using the password. So this is symmetric encryption using P. The message that would have been the message in the Diffie-Hellman protocol. And in addition to that, we also need to send the name of the client. So let's say that's Alice. When the server receives this, it can decrypt it. It knows this password. And so it obtains the value that would have been sent in the Diffie-Hellman protocol. That means it can compute a key using its secret value XB, combining that with the decrypted result here. As in the Diffie-Hellman protocol, it also sends a message back to the client. In Diffie-Hellman, that would just be G to the XB mod Q, where XB is the secret value selected by the server. Now we're going to combine that with symmetric encryption, encrypting that with the password. Alice decrypts that message, so she can also obtain the value here and obtain the key using the normal Diffie-Hellman technique. So now we'll have a quiz to see if you understand the EKE protocol. The question is, which of these are drawbacks of using the protocol as we've described it here? To authenticate a user, that would be Alice on this side, to a website, that would be the server on this side. So the first possibility is that it's vulnerable to offline dictionary attacks. This is where an attacker goes through a dictionary of common passwords, trying to guess the password of a user. The second choice is that it requires servers to store the passwords in clear text. And as we discussed in Unit 2, this is never a good idea. The third choice is it's vulnerable to meet-in-the-middle attacks, just like the Diffie-Hellman protocol was.